And I'd like to give you some hope instead of the fear that is very popular these days in our industry. Because I don't think we don't have a lot of secrets anymore, I'll share a little secret with you about me. I grew up as a child in Tel Aviv, and I was very curious and I was very fascinated with secrets. This is what I looked like when I was an aspiring young hacker. It's a real photo from my elementary school in Tel Aviv. And as I saw it in the movie, I saw hackers as the heroes. I saw them as the good guys saving the day. A bunch of high school kids outsmarting everybody, including the FBI, and showing everyone what's what. My idea for the TED stage was that hackers can actually save the day, that hackers can be the immune system for our connected age. And here's the crazy thing. Almost 2 million people felt the same way. So now I wake up every morning and I get messages from hackers from around the world, literally from West Africa and Canada and South Korea. And what they're saying is, yes, we want to help. And we keep demonstrating things and we keep talking to people, but everybody thinks we're the bad guys. How can we change the world? How can we make a difference? First of all, stop the spread of FUD. What is the FUD? Fear, uncertainty, and doubt. When you hear about fuddy sounding things, question it. Get to the facts. And then when you get the facts, tell people about it. When somebody talks to you, for example, and says, oh, a country could start cyber war in a push of a button, what I would like from you to do as a responsible security professional and somebody that cares about hope more than fear is to say, well, yeah, let's hold our horses. Here's what's happened, here's what's possible, here's what might happen, here's what we're gonna do about it. Trust and safety might be our new goal as an industry, not just our secrets. It's not credit card numbers or the people we meet on Facebook or our private, most intimate wishes. Yes, those are important too, but perhaps life-threatening things, safety things, and trustworthy devices that will power our modern way of life should come first. A suggestion. Secondly, bugs, security disclosures, and stunts will happen. But how a company, how an organization deals with them will matter even more. How you respond to it and how you then fix the problem, that's what will define the future of how secure that company will be. And the media and the public opinion makes a huge difference, not just on how afraid people are, but also on policy, on budgets, on decisions that governments can make. So when you see people starting to spread false information or FUD or just a media story getting out of hand, you can stop it. It's actually in your hands. You're actually a CSO of your own home, of your car, of the devices that you bring into your house, the things that you maybe recommend your family and friends to buy. Even if you don't run the network at your organization, you have the capacity to have safer products at home. And you can do that by actually demanding safer products from the companies that make them. You have to start thinking of yourself as the CSO of your own little family, your home, your own community. The phones, the laptops that are in your house actually depend on you. So to wrap things up, not just circus, entertainment, and prizes, sunshine and things you can do. Demand trustworthy devices from people who sell them to you and people that develop them. Fight fear with facts. Collaborate with hackers, perhaps the most important part, at least from my perspective. And if that's not enough sunshine for you, you are very much invited to Tel Aviv, where Cyber Week takes place every year in June. And it's a free conference, it's international, and we do also host B-Sides Tel Aviv as part of that. And the weather is guaranteed to be sunny or your money back. Did I mention it's a free conference? All right, I hope to see you in Tel Aviv. Thank you very much.